welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, then welcome to my corner. My name is Angela, and today's video is going to be something that I haven't done so far. It's going to be a review. It was originally going to be something different, but I received a package in the mail, and that really changed everything. So you probably know from the title already, today we're going to be reviewing, drum roll please, the new Jeffree Star Cremated Palette! Ah! Now, before I actually get into the palette and I start doing the eye look, I know there's been a lot of controversy over this palette and I don't want to bring any of that to my channel. I'm not about the drama. Everybody has their own opinion and you're more than welcome to have your own opinion. I'm not gonna share mine. This channel is only about positivity and makeup and having fun. This is a beautiful palette from one of my favorite makeup companies, and that's what we're gonna stick with. All right, so now that's out of the way, let's open the palette and see the beautiful colors. Boop. So this is the beautiful palette, all the beautiful colors, and oh my god, you guys, unbox it on Instagram. If you don't follow me on Instagram, this is gonna be my handle, go and follow me. And I lost it, because I had a different idea of how the palette would look based on everything that I saw online, and then I opened it up and I was like, this is so freaking beautiful. The colors are amazing, the glitters are like breathtaking, especially the one called Pole Bearer, this one right over here. It's so beautiful. It's like, oh. And I always wanted to get a neutral slash smoky palette, because I never do smoky eyes, mostly because I only have like the colors in like separate palettes, and I don't like dig into one palette and a different palette and etc. And I love the idea of having one palette where I can do all the smoky eyes I want. And I'm also very excited that there is a pale white eyeshadow as long as a black eyeshadow, because I don't know why there's so many palettes out there with so many beautiful colors, but they don't have the basics like a white and black, so you can have a nice white base or darken the outer corner. Honestly, funny enough, this might be mostly the reason why I wanted this palette in the first place, because of the white and the black, besides the point. So I'm not gonna do a swatching of all the colors or anything, most of the colors I'm gonna use for the eye look, because if you wanna see the full swatching of all the colors, you can go to Jeffree's channel and check the reveal of the palette. Alright, so the eye look that I wanted to do is actually the eye look that he had on the reveal of the palette. I'm gonna insert some pictures here so you can know what I'm talking about. But when I saw him wearing that smoky halo eye, I was like, I need to try that. And fun fact, when I first started doing makeup, I used to do halo eyes all the time. Nowadays, that has been an issue because I realized that I'm not as good at doing halo eyes as I used to be, which is kind of crazy to me. But besides that, I'm gonna try my best to recreate the look, and hopefully you're gonna enjoy it. So if you wanna see me transforming from this to something way better than this, then keep on watching. Alright, so first of all, I've already done my base, because I wanted to focus only on the eyeshadow today, so since it's only going to be a review of the palette. So I already primed my eyes using my Born This Way multi-purpose concealer in the color Snow. And I put a little bit of a powder on top. I used the Aerospun powder, just a little bit. I wanted it to be a little tacky as possible. So let's open up the palette and see which colors I think I should be using first. You know what? I have a better idea. I'm gonna go off camera and do the one eye and see where I wanna go, see what I wanna do, how I'm gonna fix the eye, and then come right back and show you the second eye together. So let's go. And there goes one eye done. I actually really, really like it. I'm not sure these are the exact same colors that they used for his makeup in that video, but I think it's very similar. This is my humble opinion. And this lash is like, ooh! These lashes are from Diamond X Lashes. I'm gonna have their Instagram handle somewhere in the screen. I think they're in the style Baddie, but I have to double check with that. And they're so big and spidery, I love it. The best lash for the look. Alright, so let's pull up the colors that I used. Let's show you what I did on this side. Alright, so I'm gonna start by taking this Luxie 141 mini round brush. This is the best brush when I want to stamp some of the color down, so it's nice and pigmented and I can have full control of where I want this shadow to go. So the color I'm gonna get is gonna be the Grave Digger. It's the third one right here, and I'm gonna stamp it in kind of a cat eye shape. I have hooded eyes, so I'm not gonna go where my actual crease is. I'm gonna go above that. I wanna go where I can feel my bone. If you can take your bit of the brush and touch your eyelid area, you can see where your bone stops. That's where you wanna place your eyeshadow. It's gonna be right here for me. And just like that. Just keep picking up shadow and slowly creating the shape that you want. By the way, the shadows are really, really soft and really pigmented. If you ended up seeing a Nikki tutorial video on the review of this palette, you know that she said that there's some excess pigment when you dip your brush in the pans. I would say that that's actually only for specific shadows, because for example for this Grave Digger, that I'm picking up right now, there's like no fallout on the pan. I did try, however, some of the other shadows and there is some fallout on the pans on those ones, but it's not an annoyingly amount of fallout, it's like normal. It's like the amount that you would expect a regular palette to have. So personally, I don't mind that. If that's something that you do not like in the palette, it's something to consider. But all in all, these shadows are performing amazing. They're not annoying, my pans are not getting dirty, so I think that's something good to keep in mind. So yeah, I'm just gonna go and have like a cat eye shape. So as soon as I go to the end of the eye, I'm gonna extend it upwards. Try not to extend it too high above your eyebrow, just because we're gonna blend it later and it's gonna extend even further. So keep that in mind. Then when it comes to the inner corner, you can extend it as much as you feel comfortable with. That's pretty much the top, and I'm gonna connect the bottom line. Just be careful, because you need to have the edge pointy and not too fat. So very light hand, with a very light hand. And that's about it. That's that. Now I'm gonna switch to a Morphe brush. This is the Morphe M507. It's a taper brush. So I'm gonna start from the inside and have round motions and start blending the shadow. I usually switch from round motions to windshield wiper motion. There you go. And fun fact, the person who taught me this term is my favorite beauty YouTuber, Kristen Dominique. I would watch her videos since I was 14 or 15 years old, and she would always say windshield wiper motions, so that's what I do now too. I'm going to do the bottom part as well. And that's good. And now I'm gonna switch the M562, which is a little more fluffy, so it doesn't, even if you want to, it's not gonna apply too much on the eye. So I'm gonna pick up the shadow called Wednesday. It's this one right here. I'm actually might gonna switch from Wednesday and Urology. I think that's how you pronounce it, I'm not sure. So I'm gonna mix those two shadows and use them to blend. And again, very light hand, even though this brush doesn't pick up too much pigment. So it kind of does a job for you, but you can never be too sure. It's always easier to pull little by little and build it up rather than go full on, because it's gonna be harder to come back from that. pick up another brush. A lot of brushes. This is the Morphe M433, which is the best damn brush out there for blending. And that's that. Again, it don't have to be too harsh, just a little bit. The brush has a job for you. I always say that. You don't need a lot of talent unless you have good brushes. And that's that. Now we're gonna move to the deeper colors. Alright, so for the darker color, I'm gonna pick up a brush that has no number or no name on it. It's actually an e.l.f. brush, I remember that. Yes. It's called e.l.f. Blending Eye Brush. And it kind of looks like that. It's a little shorter and fatter, so it's gonna pick up more pigment. And that's what I want at this point. So, I'm gonna go to the color. Something like that. The first one, basically the blackest color. And place it on the outer and inner corner. Like so. Still keep in mind the cat eye shape. Not 100% sure if they intended to make it look like a cat eye on him. It might just actually look like that because of the angles, but I kind of like the idea of having a cat eye halo eye, so I'm gonna try it and see how it works. So that's about the outer corner, and then I'm gonna slowly drag it inward. Very, very lightly. When you go to this part, when you're gonna connect it, you need to be very light-handed, and with the inner corner, place the color carefully. So I'm gonna leave it like that, and it's gonna look messy, but we're gonna blend it. Take the M4562 brush and use this to blend. Don't want to be a light blend at this point. As of right now, I'm not gonna add any extra color. It's gonna slowly blend the black. Be especially careful when you go to the inner corner. Take a fluffy brush and take a little bit of Wednesday and Eulogy again, because I think we lost those colors. I'll replace the black, and I'm gonna go over the harsh lines. I know you've heard everybody say that, but blending is our best friend. And again, round motions and windshield wiper motions. Lastly, I'm also gonna get the same little M4562 brush. I'm gonna take the color Life Insurance. This one right here. This is a light gray color. And I'm gonna place that on the top. Just a nice wash of gray. I wanna intensify the black, but I'm gonna wait. First, what we're gonna do is we're gonna clean the middle part, creating that halo eye. And for that, I'm gonna get a makeup wipe. You can use any makeup remover you have. I only have a makeup wipe at this point, so I'm gonna use that and try to create that halo effect by taking off your base. It's good enough. Now I'm gonna get my little mermaid brush, which is a nice flat brush. This is the one I always use for my halo eyes, or if I want to do any art on my eye. Take a little bit of my concealer, make sure the brush is nice and flat, and let's go. I like to place a little bit on the lash line, and then look up, right, left, and now you see the little line there? That's what we're going to use as a guideline. If you have hooded eyes like me, you might want to go a little above even that line, but that's totally your preference. Right now, I think that's perfectly fine. And I'm going to turn it at the top when I do this, because I don't want to mess it up. Right, there we go. Now I'm going to use a clean ring finger and tap the excess concealer off. Now I'm going to go back with the e.l.f. brush. Now I'm going to step a little more of the black, because I want it to be nice and dark and e.l.f. looking. gonna get a small packing brush, and right now I actually want to take something smaller than usual just because I want to be very precise. I'm gonna take this Morphe M213, smallest paper brush I own, and I'm actually gonna mix this shade's Diamond Ashes and Death Blue. The closer you can actually see. Like, look at that. Look at that color! I barely even tapped the brush in the pigment. That's that. Now we're gonna focus on the lower lash line. And just to mention, because I don't think if I said that before, I do have some bake on because I wanted to catch as much fallout as possible. And the other eye, I didn't have almost any fallout, honestly. I don't think this eye is gonna have anything, but you know, just in case, just to be sure. So for the lower lash line, I'm first gonna go with some black eyeliner, and the one that I have right now, it's one that I got on a BoxyCharm. I don't think I know of this company. Hollywood and Vine. Vine, something like that. Anyways, so I'm gonna go with that and line the lower lash line. Not the waterline, the lower lash line. As close as possible. Don't worry if it's a little messy because we're gonna blend the line out later. While your eyeliner looks like that, we're gonna get a small short taper brush. This one is a Moda Pro brush and it looks like this. And we're firstly gonna use it with no eyeshadow on and we're gonna blend the line. Just going again, windshield wiper motions. She looks something like that. And then now we're gonna use the black shadow again called Hears. And we're gonna place that right on top of the liner. So she looks something like that. And now we're gonna try and make it a little more symmetrical by taking again this small Morphe M562 brush and take the colors Wednesday and Eulogy. Mix them together and blend the black eyeshadow outwards. Make sure to also connect it to the wing we've created with our shadow. Buildable, so you're never gonna have an issue with putting too much at once. Thank God. Take your time. And try to build the shadows. Now, the shade Eulogy, that's one of the shades that's actually has a lot of cakeback on the pan, but at least it doesn't stain. So I can just tap it, look at the pan, and then blow it away, and that's it. So it's, at least it's not a big deal, you know what I'm saying? As long as the palette looks nice and clean, and I don't have to worry about that. I personally don't mind. Go back the big fluffy M433 brush and get a little bit of the life insurance, just a little bit, and blend everything together so everything can seem nice and seamless. Alright, and that's that. Now, for the inner waterline, I'm gonna use a NYX White Jumbo Eye Pencil, I'm sorry. And I'm gonna line my waterline. And I can't believe I did that with one hand. Honestly, very proud of myself.
So that's for the lower lash line, and I'm gonna use some eyeliner because the line thick enough so I can put the lashes on. And the one that I'm using is my favorite, which is the Physicians Formula eyeliner, which is amazing because, oh my god, it's just so easy to use, lasts long, you can take it off really easy. I can do it, honestly, I can do a whole video just looking about the eyeliner, but this is a different video. So there goes my line, nice, quick, and easy, just like I like it. Now we're gonna curl our lashes up and get the fake eyelashes ready. And the mascara I'm gonna use is this, I think this was, it's a Tarte mascara. I can't even say the name, I think it's Big Ego. Yeah, that's about it. And I'm gonna put that real quick on my lashes. We're also gonna do the lower lash line. Alright. And now for the eyelashes. So the glue that I'm using is this black glue called Super Strip Lash Adhesive. From the brand AOA, and you can find it on the site shopmissa.com for maybe like $1.88 or something like that, and it's flipping amazing. You can get it in black and white, and I have both, and they're worth the money. They're amazing, and I highly recommend it. And the way I put my lashes on right now, I actually put the adhesive on the actual lash line, and then I place the lashes on top, which makes it way easier and less messy. Let it sit for a couple of seconds. And while we do that, I'm gonna take the small, the flat brush that we used earlier to place the glitter in the middle of the eye to highlight the brow bone. Same thing, mixing the bath blue with the diamond ashes and placing it underneath my brow bone. But for this one, I'm actually gonna spray my brush. Blend that out a little bit, as always, just so it doesn't look that harsh. Perfect. Same color combo for the inner corner as well. Alrighty, so now let's move for your lashes. Again, this is a Diamond X Lashes in the style Batty. I'm just gonna pick them up with my hand and place them where I place the glue on my eyes. Bam! Look how quick and how easy, and I didn't have to even use tools to put that on. Making sure it's where I want it to be and press it upwards. I love my lashes to be looking up, not straight. I don't think anybody wants that. And this eye look is done! Ah! I'm actually so happy. Look at it, it looks so hot! Sorry. Let's dust off the big. And again, I don't even see any fallout, so again, it's always a plus. Nice bonus. And as I said, I've already done my base, but I kept the highlight for last because I didn't know what I wanted to do. I'm not sure if I want to use diamond ashes or if I do something else. I'm actually excited to combine something. Let's just spray our
her face with this Beauty Creation setting spray in cucumber. Set everything down. And with that, let's finish off our face. For highlight, I'm actually gonna combine, like I said, the Nikki Tutorials XO Freckle Lab in Clay's Donut and a little bit of the Diamond Ashes, because, oh, why not? I'm not going anywhere, I'm just staying home in my quarantine, so might as well go all the way. Alright, I'm gonna put a little bit of spray in my brush. Mix both of these beauties and let's see. Ooh. Yep, me lucky. Oh, this is so nice. Yep, I agree with my choice, and I think it was the smart choice. I actually feel bad that I have nowhere to go. I need people to see me like this. That looks so freaking nice. Now the nose. Actually, before I highlight my nose, I'm gonna fix my nose contour a little bit, because I think I kinda got ruined with doing all this. I'm using my Too Faced Cocoa Contour Powder and the two middle colors with my contour powders, and then my nose contour a little bit. Same brush that I use for my powder to fix the sides. Alright, and now we're gonna go with the highlight. Ooh, that was intense. A little bit of the bridge between the eyebrows. Top of the eyebrows, my chin, and a little bit of the lips. Why the hell not? Now onto the lippies. This is the Stila Caramello, and as you can tell, I'm almost out of it because I love it so much. And I'm gonna try to scrape as much as I can out and outline my lips and fill them in as well. So my camera stopped recording very rudely while I was doing my lips, so I'm just gonna show you what I used. On top, I used my favorite lip gloss from Lime Crime and Wet Cherry, and the color is Sparkling Cherry. And you guys, if you haven't smelled this ever, if you see them anywhere, please go and smell them, because they smell fucking amazing! They smell like cherry candy, and oh my god, I could eat these, I swear. And done! And now, with this lip completed, this eye look and this whole makeup tutorial is finished! Now, let me go and change my hair, change my outfit, maybe do something more special, and I'm gonna be back with the full transformation. Amazing, and I have nowhere to go. That's besides the point. Alright, so let me know if you liked the look. Do you think I did good? Do you think it was close to what he was wearing? Either way, I'm in love with this, and I highly, highly recommend this palette in case come back, because I know he said he's gonna restock it around June, so keep an eye out. Highly, highly recommend. And let me know if you want me to do any more looks, if you like me reviewing this palette, if you like more reviews and more looks like that. If you have any more ideas, you can just leave them down below. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the little notification bell and follow me on my socials. And thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you later.